discrete dipole approximation. So please, whenever you're ready.
So hello everyone, my name is Stefania Glukhova, and today I'm going to talk about the implementation of various Bessel beams in the framework of discrete dipole approximation. First of all, I'd like to tell a few words about Bessel beams, then how and why we need to implement Bessel beam scattering simulation, and then about Bessel beam generalization, and finally about the implementation and results. So, quite popular Bessel beams belong to the class of n-directional beams. Moreover, they are able to reconstruct its profile in contact with the small particles, as it's shown in the picture above. The main parameters of Bessel beam is its order and half-cone angle, presented of the Bessel beam generation scheme below. So, application sphere of Bessel beams is presently vast, and one of the most popular, of course, it's optical manipulation, in particular optical tweezing. Also, Bessel beams are used in material processing, laser cooling, and many other spheres. Depending on the Bessel beam order, it may have its maximum or minimum on the center. There are also various vectorial Bessel beam types, and on the pictures you can see the electric field magnitude profile for different Bessel beams for the second order in a non-paraxial case. As you may know, the scattering of the Bessel beams has been studied mostly for the simple particles such as spheres or spheroids. But the main goal of this work is to implement the more general Bessel beam scattering simulation. That means that the scattering particles may be arbitrary. It's also important to implement the most frequently used Bessel beams. And it is, in addition, it must be easy to simulate a scattering of more complicated or specific Bessel beams. So the discrete dipole approximation is a method that allows to simulate scattering by the arbitrary particles. And in this method, the scattering particle is divided on the cubical subvolumes that can be replaced by the point dipoles. And the resulting scattering field could be found considering dipole interaction with each other and the incident light. It's important to note that this method is numerically exact, and one of the most popular DDA implementation is an ADDA open source code. ADDA allows to calculate various scattering quantities such as scattering matrices, scattering cross sections, and many others. And here we want to add Bessel beams as a new incident light. So let's start with the classical framework of the scattering matrices. As you may know, amplitude and Mueller matrices provide the most complex and general information about the scattering process. And the amplitude matrix that can be found using, for example, the ADDA method relates incident and scattering electric fields. So here it's important to determine two polarizations of the incident electric field. That's why it's important to thoroughly examine our new beams. And one of the common approach of the Bessel beam derivation is the Davis approach, with Hertz vector potentials that are solutions of Maxwell equations in the cylindrical coordinate system. So here, electric and magnetic field could be found using these two potentials, Hertz vector potentials of electric and magnetic fields. And these expressions could be written in a matrix form using the matrix operator L. And on this step, we present matrix operator M for each Bessel beam type. This operator transforms a polarization vector of the beam to its potential vector. And the previous equation could be written in this form. Let's consider the properties of such approach. Different beam polarizations can be related by their rotation on some angle. And this transformation could be written with matrix M formalism as a rotation of polarization vector, like this. The same logic can be applied to the coupled Bessel beam types related by the duality transformation. So here we rotate the potential vector, like this. It can be simply presented on this table. So as you can see, X and Y polarizations of LE and LM Bessel beam types could be related with the rotation transformation R and both these types are related with duality transformation P. It is also was found that any other Bessel beams could be presented as linear combinations of these four Bessel beams. So let's move to the realization in other code. So it is available on a GitHub for anyone. And here is two common line examples for Bessel beam of LE type and the generalized Bessel beam. And here is the result. On these two graphs, you can see the comparison of the scattering intensities in two planes obtained with the DDA method and generalized Lorentz mean theory. Here, CS Bessel beam of the second or of the zero order scattered on a sphere. And the next, there is the same comparison, but the scattering particle is a coated sphere. As you can see, both results are in a perfect agreement with the generalized Lorentz mean theory. So here is the conclusion of my speech. So all the known Bessel beam types have been classified and generalized, and now all of them can be presented using four complex parameters corresponding to the matrix operator M. So all of these types are implemented in undercode and available on the GitHub. So results was tested with the generalized Lorentz mean theory, and now anyone can simulate Bessel beam scattering. So thank you for your attention.